thank you very much, Annette. Many thanks to all of at UEBB in Kassel who have made this possible today and to show our ideas of a future Europe. And nevertheless, explain to all of you what the Lego bricks are all about. Welcome from my side. My name is Clemens Aschermann. At my side tonight, also from the Vision 10 team, Jonas Wartling and Jan Aschermann, and they will show us a live demo from the Erasmus platform. So before we start, why this initiative? We see a great lack of transparency and cooperation with regard to digitalization. That's something Europe can do better. We want to play a part in making digitization more successful in the future. So who launched this initiative? On the student side, the consulting team based at the University of Göttingen and at the University of Clausthal. And on the company side, the company Simpecon from Hildesheim in Lower Saxony.
The consulting team is as a club in Göttingen and Clausthal Zellerfeld, run by students, from different courses of studies, and we combine the theory from the from the studies with we combine it in projects with our experiences to help local companies in nearby Göttingen and Clausthal Zellerfeld. And that's it about the consulting team.
So Supercon is a consulting house with two parts of expertise, sub-solutions worldwide in more about 40 or 50 countries worldwide. And the second part is the IT project management in all its perspective. And because we are talking with the EBB in Kassel today, one of our customers is the SMA in Kassel. And for all participants around Kassel, we helped to equip the SMA national companies in India and Australia as well. Some short activities we did the last years, the last 20 years in Europe. There were three big harmonizing projects we saw in Europe. Of course, the currency conversion, the Euro-Umstellung. And the second was the single European payment area. We all know this IBAN number. And we helped our companies, our customers to manage this. And what is still ongoing is the e-invoicing project all over Europe. There's the EU norm EN16931, where invoices and data, and invoices data could be managed automatically, digitally. And that's always ongoing. So what's the core of Vision 10? We think with high beams. The 10 stands for the 10-year horizon in which we think. So now for the Lego puzzle, we recognize it's all there. What do we mean by that? We have learned that everything necessary to be successful in digitalization is available. Great universities with modern degree programs, students who pursue innovative ideas, many companies that are on the air, that are on their way on the future, and some institutions, for instance, Chamber of Commerce. But the combination, the collaboration is not optimized in Germany and in Europe as well as we saw it. So we have just to put these different players together through transparency and a wealth of event forms. So connecting science and business sustainable. That's what we stand for. And the main thing is the innovation transfer for companies who are not located at a university site. And you may have not the personal capacities for communication and cooperation with universities. And we bring the solution for those companies. The big challenges and the big shortcoming currently, lack of transparency. Many companies do not know what is happening at the universities in their hometown. University is often still seen as an, I hope it's translated right, ivory tower. And that's our picture from the future. Universities at the left side, companies at the right side, students as an own player will cooperate. So how do we envision cooperation? This is the old view of the transition from study to work. We want to forget this picture. And that's our picture of the way from study to work. Getting to know companies in the early stage of the studies and preferable in different industries. So we recommend to do these things in different companies to know what is going on in the real life. And at the end, maybe what we prefer is bachelor or master thesis with topics that can be practice oriented. So the great advantage for students, the main advantage, single point of contact to companies that support the idea and the principles. So we strictly recommend at one point to pay internships. In addition to that, what the EU support is in place. So two main advantages for a company. One is single point of contact. I have contact to a lot of universities in Germany, in Europe, over one single point of contact. And with this also in all areas of expertise in information technology, which are covered by our initiative. One very important point is the point of innovation. So you receive innovation impulses when you take students into your company. So also for universities, it's a big chance to have a single point of contact into the business side. So some event forms which we carry out, Corona condition, currently online. One is the Forum Vision 10, it's duration of 90 minutes, where people have the chance to meet partners from us and get to know, among other things, partner introduce themselves in sessions about 30 minutes. At Pitch and Pizza, the focus is on innovative new ideas. Startups may pitch. Students may pitch their bachelor piece or master thesis. Two per pitch and pizza sessions, so 15 minutes each, and at the end, 15 minutes in Q&A. So 45 minutes overall. And it's pitch and pizza because we do it at lunchtime from 12 to 12:45. And third is what we call Zusammenspiel. We just play with students at their hometown, at their home university. And then we have some examples. This was a meeting with PhD students in Gifhorn, where the IAV is located, a company who is serving services to the automotive industry. And the PhD students presented their work. And in the same meeting were people from the company. And from this meeting started some cooperations between the TU Clausthal and the IAV in Gifhorn. So this is an example where we invited students from Göttingen to the CeBIT Information Technology Fair in Hanover. And the guest there is Bill McDermott, the CEO of the SAP SE Worldwide. This is a more or less internal workshop where we met in at the University of Lüneburg. On the right side, this is the Liebeskind building, very famous, very, very smart. And in this workshop, we just think about how can we do Vision 10 better and what's the future of Vision 10. There were people from the Chamber of Commerce and from the ERV, there's the one from the TU Clausthal. So a mixture of participants. So this is an example where we met the company Sennheiser in Hamburg. Sennheiser ST, Sennheiser Streaming Technologies, is a startup from Sennheiser, which brings new solutions for people, don't know the right word, who are not healthy in their ears. And that's a technology which they can support it very, very, very good. So this is an example where we met in this Zusammenspiel with the Erasmus Student Network Hildesheim. Everybody has a Lego brick and was a lot of fun. I think maybe 10 or 11 different countries were in the room. And as you can see, everybody's laughing and I think it's a lot of fun. So that's the bridge to the Erasmus Student Network, to our claim, what we prefer for this evening, unsere Region vor Augen, Europa im Blick. So why we are committed to digitization in Europe? And here's a brief digression. So let's talk about the biggest data-driven companies in the world. You all know Apple, Amazon, Google, Microsoft, and Facebook, but to be honest, who knows Tencent, Alibaba, JD.com, and Baidu? Chinese giants playing in the same league. And the main question is, where is Europe in this global map? And the answer is, it's here. Europe, on the digital landscape worldwide, is a third world country, is not existent. And this might be shocking if you see this, but it's the true and it's the status of today. And for that, there are many reasons, and there's no chance to discuss this evening, but we want to change this. And for this, this is one reason for the building of the Vision 10 initiative and the promoting of Erasmus+. So millions of students have spent a semester abroad at a European university outside their home country. So Erasmus is a success story. But Erasmus+ is a lot more than going from university to university. There's one possibility to go from university to a company, from company to company. So there's also support from Brussels for this. And also there's support for schools. So the message is for this portal, the EU will offer, it's easy and it's fast.
First, we have some basic information. And first we have some basic information, and the first thing we add is the position name, which for and so this is the short description of the internship that you offer in this platform. Second thing we have to fill in is the description of the internship, which is for us pre-wrote sentences. And you can also write some more text and just copy and paste it in here. Also, we have the duration of the internship. For us, it is 3 months. You have the choice to go from 2 months until 12 months. And you can also add a period where the internship is offered. So for us, it is the 1st of October 2021 until the 31st, March 31st of 2022. And in this period, we have an internship of 3 months. You can also say a deadline for this internship, which we choose to be the 1st of August. So now we're in the category field of studies, and we select the most fitting ones for our internship, which is communication and information science. And also down here in the drop-down menu, it is mathematics and or informatics. So those two are fitting best and we choose them. You can also check many more if they are fitting for your internship, but for us, it is these both. So after that, we have the compensation, and you can choose between no financial compensation and financial compensation. And if you choose financial compensation, as we do, you have the choices, some choices to specify it if you want. And the next thing we have to fill out is the commitment, if it's part-time, full-time, or just some days in the week. For us, it is full-time. And you can also add, after that, you can also add some keywords for this internship. I already did this when testing it. And we have things like European Union, SAP, and also e-invoicing, which is fitting best for the described internship. You can also say that there are years of experience required, but for us it is no. So you can choose yes, no, or just don't give some information. After that, we have a very small block, digital opportunities traineeship. So if something in the described field here is fitting for your internship, you can say, yes, it is a digital opportunity traineeship, which for us is fitting. And it is in the field of installation, maintenance, and management of IT systems and networks. The next step is the location for our internship that we offer. And first, of course, we have to fill in a country. For us, it is Germany, and a city, it is Hanover. And you can choose up to three different locations. So you can also add some more if you want. Here we have some requirements. So you can choose if there are some, if the level of studies is a short cycle or equivalent, bachelor, master, or PhD. For us, it is the bachelor, but also, of course, you can participate in this internship if you are a master student. So this is the minimum level of studies. The language we have selected is English and German in the level of independent user B1. And you can also add languages just by clicking on the fitting language down here if you want to add more. You can also remove it. And down here, you can add some another skill. So you can just write some skill, but we don't do that here. So the last part in English again. At the very bottom of this form, we have the box additional information where we can insert a link, which we have done here with our website link. And you can also attach some documents such as PDFs or DocX. And this can be a kind of PDF for the internship that you offer. Also, you can add some additional informations where you can just type in whatever information you have concerning the internship that you want to offer. Down here, which is the last part, is the part of notifications. And Yeah, you can choose if you want to be informed by email, or yeah, by the email you have typed in at the portal, or just a custom email address. Otherwise, you are informed in this portal. So when you log in, you get notifications if someone has applied on your internship. So the last thing you have to do is click on save. The internship SAP consultant implementing e-invoicing for European countries has been created. So this should have worked. And next, Jonas shows you how it continues from a student's perspective. Thank you.
So, all right, we start here at the website erasmusintern.org. It's the same website where Jan was. And I'm a student. I want to do an internship. So the most important point on this site for me is right here, internships. And that's where I go. And now we have a lot of internships we can apply for in Europe. Exactly, it's over 1,000 matching results, and we have a lot of opportunities to filter our search results. And I'm starting with a degree. I'm doing a bachelor's degree, so it would be the best point right here. Digital opportunities, that's what Jan also said. It depends. If it's important to you, please click yes. If no, then no. And in my case, I click yes. Categories of digital opportunities, traineeships. One thing I have to tell you, what I'm going to try is to find the I don't know how to say the thing Jan did right now. So I'm gonna look for, oh, it's actually here, but let's pretend it's not here. I'm look again. So what is important for me? I think it is with this one. It's getting less and less, and right now it's already just 13 matching results. That is one opportunity to search for matching internships. There are many more, like duration, like 3 months, financial compensation. But please only click those which are really important and necessary to you. Otherwise, you miss maybe some important internships in the search results. So I'm gonna finish this. 3 months, financial compensation, and there's already just one internship left, and that's the one from Jan, like the Simpacon. Here we get a lot of information, like durations or a commitment, and quite nice description and some requirements. All right, okay. And the last thing you have to do is just click apply, and then Clemens and Jan will get a notification and you're in. All right, now in German, two possibilities to look for internships. Just use the search option or the filter option, or use both. Yeah, you're free. And that's the easiest way to get internships in Europe. Thank you.
So who could join the team? I think everybody, students, employees, members of ESN, of Pulse of Europe, CIOs, CEOs, representatives from institutions. So the bigger the network is, the better it works. And as you see, the Lego brick is our main brick for cooperation. And everybody who has no brick at home If you want to, you can send us a message, you can send us a mail, you can use a QR code to get in contact with the initiative. And I promise everybody who sent us his postal address will have a legal break in the next day at home. So that's the way you can contact. And again, everybody may contact us.